Today, a simple but very cool tutorial on how to make Illustrator poly art effects, as well as some neat bonus effects in Photoshop towards the very end. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics. I didn't upload a video yesterday because I was snowed under with graphic design work. Today I have a very cool tutorial that shows you a poly art effect in Illustrator. I'm using Illustrator for the initial poly art effect because the pen tool is easier to use than Photoshop, and also to make the poly shapes takes a lot less time in Illustrator. First thing we need to do for this Illustrator poly art effect is to lock the image. We do not want it moving around at all. Grab the eyedropper tool and then pick some colors from your image. And then with the pen tool, start drawing some small poly shapes like so. Keep using the eyedropper tool to get the right colors and try to follow the same shape or contour as your image using poly shapes. We can use a direct selection tool to edit our poly shapes whenever we need to. Here you can see that I'm working on the eye of the bird from a poly art effect. We can check our progress by selecting all of the poly shapes and then dragging them off to one side, before pressing Command Z to go back one step. Here you can see my progress that I've made. It does take quite a lot of time with this poly art effect in Illustrator, but I think it looks really neat. Also, don't forget to keep saving your work on a regular basis. You never know when your computer or your software might crash. Try to use shades of color that represent shadow or light, because this will give your poly art effect more depth and it's going to make everything look more appealing. Here is my finished design. We could technically stop here, but I have some really cool bonus effects for you next in Photoshop. Move your vector poly art from Illustrator to Photoshop. Then create a new layer or a rectangle shape, and then place it behind the poly art effect. You will then add a gradient overlay that is radial rather than linear, and which goes from a subtle grey colour to white. Make another layer that is black in colour, and then add a lens flare to it. Choose the settings you feel look best for your design, and then change the layer blend mode to linear dodge. As you can see, I've placed a lens flare layer over the top of everything. You can experiment with what works best for you. I will also take the eraser tool and clean everything up on the lighting behind. To finish off the poly art effect, I'm going to add another small lens flare directly onto my bird. And here you have it, a very cool Illustrator poly art effect tutorial with some Photoshop bonus effects too. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and subscribe for 6 graphic design uploads per week. Let me know in the comment section below if you found this video helpful and if you have any more suggestions. So until next time, design your future today. Peace.